And now, to entertain you tonight with a gala discussion and a recording session, Matt and Greg and the fabulous Beach Boys talk.
What's up, everybody? What's up, Matt? How you doing? Oh, Matt, you're muted. Dang it.
I am on mute. Hello, dang hello. It. I'm doing pretty well. How you doing?
Thought we're going to have a flawless opening there, but that it wouldn't be Beach Boys talk if we didn't have technical issues. So welcome, everybody. Welcome in. You're in the right place. We are... You're welcome to Beach Boys Talk. It is a live stream show happening right now. That means it's live, going on right now every Tuesday night, dedicated to our favorite band in the entire world, the Beach Boys. Right, Matt?
That's right. Thank you all for being here with us tonight. If you're new, welcome. Greg and I are not experts, musicologists, historians, especially about the Beach Boys.
We're not even smart.
We're just fans of the band.
Yeah.
You know, we think they're the greatest American band of all time, probably the greatest band of all time. And we just like to get together and talk about them.
Yeah.
And every once in a blue moon, we get really cool people with the chat, but also other cool people to talk about the band with. And tonight we have an incredible person to speak to talk with, who has her own musical career in her own right. And of course her father is the very famous and we think he's a genius, Brian Wilson. That's Wendy Wilson is going to be our guest tonight, so
Wendy,
so excited.
Wendy's on our show.
Can't wait to ask her about her experiences as a rock and roll star and growing up as a child of the Beach Boys.
Rock,
you know,
and roll star, a TV star, she's been on TV.
Everything awesome. So
I'm really looking
forward to it. So we're looking forward to that. It's going to be awesome.
By the way, Matt, I think we would be remiss if we didn't mention a very big thank you to Annie Wilson Cargis for helping us connect with Wendy. We love you so much. You're awesome.
Yes.
We think you're the best, and we miss you terribly. But we continue. We're going to have a lot of fun. Wendy will be joining us here shortly. But before we do that, we want to say hi to all of our chat over here, everybody. You can see. Oh, you can't see my. Hold on. I have a Wilson. I have Shadows and Light right next to me here.
Which
is a pretty awesome album, by the way. Boop, boop, boop. Make sure you guys give that a listen. But over here, everybody to my right and my brother's, well, your left, my brother's left, you can see the chat. And everything is live right now. So you guys can chat. Like Jeff says, listening from England. Awesome, Jeff. Thank you for being up so late. We appreciate it. Daddy Bog, 1964 Beach Boys, sang it on Ed Sullivan. That's right. Claire, hi, Claire. We see Claire. We see McCrenna. We see Stacy. Everybody, Stacy is one of the wonderful people that runs our Billy Hinchy group. So make sure you join that if you're not a member on Facebook. We do a Live from Billy's Place rerun about once a month. It's really fun. Everybody, they all get together there. So welcome. If you're new to the show, if this is your first time tuning in, welcome. You're in a great place, especially if you're a Beach Boy fan. Why don't you tell us maybe where you're from, general area, and then how about your favorite Beach Boys song? How about that? Favorite Beach Boys song. We'd love to hear from you. Why don't we do this, Matt, as we do at the beginning of every show. We do a little tribute to the late, great Billy Hinchy, who had a live stream show just like this every Saturday night, and he had on the most amazing guests, and that guy, you know, Billy could tell stories for days. I mean, and they're all so interesting. We did last week a rerun of his show, and it was all about Desi Arnaz and Dino and like that whole group of people there, which I thought was really interesting. So it was really fun. We do a tribute to him every show. Go ahead, Matt. I'm sorry.
Well, I was going to say also, not to mention the fact that he was an incredible musician. You can see that on the show when he plays guitar.
Oh,
and then he skips the piano. But I mean, he was in the, if you don't know who he was, he was in the Beach Boys band for quite some time too. So
thank you.
And he toured with the Brian Wilson band, you know, later. And I was able to see him a couple times during the Pet Sounds tour, which was really cool. So anyway.
All right. This is for Billy.
Rest in peace, Billy.
I'm doing okay myself. friends talk about them good old days. We laugh and say, hey, hey, it'll have okay. Things are getting nice and easy now. It's a brand new year. And lots of things are happening. And hey, good things are coming my way.
By the way, good job, brother. But thank Wendy, you. When Brian Wilson talks about that song, he says that was kind of a tribute to Frankie Valli, which is interesting.
Really cool.
That doesn't sound as much of a like a Four Seasons vibe song to me, but it is about a girl. The Four Seasons have a lot of songs about with names in the titles. And then yeah. I guess the, you know, that part is kind of
yeah.
like Four Seasons. Yeah. yeah. Anyway.
Four Seasons were all about the girl names, man.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah. yeah. Are how many Beach Boys songs have female names in them?
You know, we've talked about that before. Can you name them all? Not quite as many. I don't know. Lana is one, right? Lana. Off the Surfing USA album.
Okay.
Wendy.
Wendy. Barbara Ann.
Barbara Ann.
Candy Girl. Just kidding. That's not even a girl's name, and it's not even the right band.
Deirdre. If you want to count that one.
Come on, Beach Boy Talkers. Come on, chat. What else?
Sherry, she needs me. That wasn't released.
Oh, Susie Cincinnati.
Susie Cincinnati.
Barbie. Was Barbie
Mona.
One? Mona.
Barbie's early. Mona from Mona? I Love You.
Okay.
Peggy Sue. From MIU.
Annalie the Healer. Nice buzz.
Annalie the Healer.
Oh,
my
Betsy.
Diane.
Ballad of Old Betsy.
Ballad of Old Betsy.
Forgot about. Oh, Caroline. No, Matthew.
And again, my Diane. Yeah,
Steve,
Caroline.
Help me,
no.
Rhonda. Dang it. We
oh,
were,
help me, Rhonda.
We,
duh,
we stink. Lady Linda.
Lady Linda.
Yeah, Caroline. No, was a pretty big miss. That's a good one. I love Annalie the Healer. Might be one of my favorite songs. I love that song so much. It's such a nice vibe. I love it.
Yeah.
But speaking of nice vibes, Matt, why don't we get into our. My favorite segment of the show where Matt totally spills his vibes. And that, of course, is called The Many Moods of My Big Brother, Matt. Let's get into it.
The Many Moods of Matt.
Oh, yeah.
David, I have to call you out because... Marcella, that was another one we forgot. So good call on that
one. Oh, Marcella's good.
One arm over my shoulder. Okay.
That's a good one.
I had to take a trip over Memorial Day weekend. And when I do that, sometimes I have time to listen to music. And I got to say, I did something interesting this time just because I hadn't listened to either album in a while. So I listened to the Smile Sessions.
Yeah.
And I listened to Smiley Smile.
Okay.
Smiley Smile's a little bit later. Mm-hmm. You know, obviously it came out after.
Sure.
I guess my question tonight would be, has anybody ever gone out there and put a record on or put a thing on you thought you really liked? And then when you listen to it again, it's not quite the same. I guess that's the vibe I'm feeling tonight. I got to be honest with you. When I put on the Smile Sessions, there's parts of that are brilliant. And I'm just talking about the... you know, the main tracks, not the, you know, there's like five CDs. I'm just talking about the sequence that they build it based off of Brian Wilson Presents Smile.
Okay.
You know, and then you have the heavy hitters. You have Our Prayer, Heroes and Villains, Cabin Essence, Surf's Up, you know, Wonderful, Good Vibrations. Mm-hmm. But to me, the other songs in there, I know they're not complete because they're Smile Sessions, but they're not, they just seem like a lot of musical ideas that don't have a, they're not a finished product anyway. And I, when I heard myself listening to it, I frustrating. It sounds dated to me. The lyrics really bothered me, and it got me thinking about
you're still talking about the Smile Sessions.
I'm talking about Smile Sessions. Yeah, okay, the lyrics bothered me too.
I'm with you. Okay.
And so I wonder sometimes too, what were they wrong? Was Brian wrong in kind of holding Mike out? Because Mike wrote the lyrics to Good Vibrations, which, you know, and then, but then anyway, then my other question about it is, so I'm not a big fan. I thought I liked the Smile Sessions more, but this last time I listened to it, it was underwhelming to me. And I can't exactly explain why. It sounded dated to me. It didn't sound that progressive. It sounded almost like somebody trying too hard. I know I get stoned for that, but that's what it sounded like to me. And then the other interesting thing was when I went to Smiley Smile, Smiley Smile is way more mellow. It's way more weird, you know, but it seems more cohesive to me. And it seems more like a Beach Boys record because it's not so grand and like, you know, it's not like a symphony, like this orchestral rock opera he was trying to write.
Yeah.
And again, Getting Hungry on there. There's a couple songs that Mike writes as well. So I guess what I would say overall is I think Smile is brilliant. I do. But when you put it in the context of the Beach Boys, I'm not so sure how, what it would have done. And the bigger thing, Greg, I guess I'd like to hear from you in the chat is, have you ever gone back to a Beach Boy record and you put it on and it was kind of disappointing to me. I don't know how to explain it this time. So it's been on my mind, like trying to find out why, but anyway, that's what I wanted to say. Hope that made sense. I might have meandered a little bit, but do you kind of get what I'm saying?
I do. So I remember remember the show Power Rangers?
Yeah.
That I was obsessed with that show when I was little. I loved it so much. And then probably when I was in my mid-20s, I went back and watched it. So, like, we're talking probably a solid 10, 15 years later, right? It was terrible. I think sometimes, so I've had that feeling before, not necessarily with Beach Boys records, so I can't get with you on that one, but what I will say, Matt, is I do think that sometimes, you know, at the end of the day, you and I are the same. We tend to listen to the same band all the time, and we are really lucky in that I think the Beach Boys have enough material that spans so many decades and so many different sounds that it's very easy to not get tired. But on the other hand, it's like, dude, you've been listening to this stuff for how long now? You know what I mean? And I think eventually it's going to get to a point where not everything is always lining up with what you like. And so I would imagine that there's going to be, so I get my question for you is, do you feel like it's a phase where, like, for right now, I'm not into the Smile stuff, or is it definitive? Like, man, I really just, has it been happening for a while where, man, I just really don't love the Smile stuff?
Well, I kind of listened to it like in sequence. So I listened to the Today album, and again, that one's still brilliant to me. I can never get enough of that album. And then I listened to Summer Days, which we've talked about before.
Yeah. Yeah.
I skipped Party. And then I listened to Pet Sounds. And to me, and then I listened to Smile Sessions and then Smiley Smile.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pet Sounds is so much better than Smile. And again, it's probably not fair to compare it to Smile because Smile never came out the way Brian Wilson intended or the Beach Boys. I get that, but I'm just talking about what we have. Pet Sounds is just, because Pet Sounds is still cohesive. It's still musical. It's not weird. It's the Beach Boys at their prime vocals, Brian. You know what I mean?
Sure.
And so it's almost like Smile Sessions, if you listen to them that way in an order like that, is kind of a letdown. But it could be because it was not complete. You know, that might just be what I'm dealing with there. But even Smiley Smile, again, makes more sense as a concept album than the Smile Session. So I don't know if it's a phase or what. I just, you know, again, Surf's Up is brilliant. Heroes and Villains, Cabin Essence, but I'm just talking about, but then when you have all the filler in there, you know, even Vegetables, I don't know. The lyrics are a little bit crazy for me. I really tried. I had a lot of time to listen to it, and I just started listening. I was like, what is this? I wonder if people would have liked it in the 60s anyways, you know? So,
yeah, sometimes I wish with Beach Boys stuff that, I actually wish this with a lot of things in my life, but I think most people do. But you wish that you could go back and listen to things the very first time again. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, because every listen is ultimately like piled on to every listen you've ever done, and eventually that's gonna, I don't know. I think when I listened to Smile stuff the first time, you know, blew me away, and then when I really got into it, I thought it was crazy, and I still think had it come out, I think it'd be like the greatest thing ever. I do think so. I mean, Our Prayer is,
Yeah.
For some reason, our prayer gets overlooked, and I'm not really sure why, but that might be the most beautiful Brian Wilson composition, I think, in the catalog. But
I can't disagree with that. I would, that's what I want to make clear though. I'm not, if I'm cutting on anybody in this, and I don't mean to criticize, it's more the lyrics. Like the lyrics I tend you. To find myself more siding with Mike Love these days, which is funny. The music is brilliant. Okay. Like you said, Our Prayer, Heroes and Villains, even Wind Chimes has great music in it, yeah. Especially in the middle. Doom, 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 doom. But the lyrics, though it's hard, I try not to look at my wind chime. It just, you know what I mean? I'm like, what were they going for here, you know? And the part at the end of On a Holiday when it goes, whispering winds and yeah. I mean, again, brilliant. So I think it's some of Brian Wilson's most inspired music, and it's unfortunate it didn't come out. But I guess I'm just talking about the Smile sessions as a whole.
Yeah.
When you put them on and listen to it, I kind of listened to it, and I was like, you know, I could take this or leave it, you know, give me the highlights, you know what I mean? So that's,
yeah,
I just never thought I would think that about a Beach Boys release like that of such great magnitude as the Smile Sessions. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. That's interesting.
And to be honest with you, I think as a whole album, I'd rather listen to Smiley Smile, as weird as it is. It just, it has more of a flow, more of a vibe to it to me, you know? So I'm not saying it's better. I'm just saying I'd rather listen to it.
Yeah. 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 I love Little Pad. I think that's got yeah. such a cool vibe, and I wish they would have chased that a little bit. And I guess they did in some ways, but
Little Pad With Me Tonight is so brilliant. You know, the there's just a couple songs on there that are really pretty. So I don't know. I guess in the chat, I guess so. I was at. Have you listened to an album like that, Greg? Where you? I know you talked about Power Rangers, but have you had a Beach Boys experience like that or not really?
Where I'm trying to think if I really fell hard for an album and then later on decided I really didn't like it as much anymore. Well, chat, maybe the chat has some chat. Any Beach Boy records that you've cooled on recently or cooled on completely at some time where it was, you fell hard for something and then kind of took a step back and was like,
hey,
I
Greg,
really
look who's in the chat like, is Dr. Beach Boy. Dirk's here. Hey, Dirk.
Hey, the OG.
I know.
Dirk might have been on the very first episode we ever have. It might have been like Dirk and Claire. We had like two people watching. So, Dirk, we're happy you're here. Dr. Beach Boy.
He said, I prefer the Smile, Wonderful, and Wind Chimes than the Smiley. Oh, I do. I do, too.
Yeah.
Most definitely. And Bill Larson, his comment passed me, but it said something about, you have to remember that these tracks weren't finished or complete.
Yeah,
I get
that's
that.
Fair. That's
and
fair.
That's why I'm talking about as a release. I'm not saying this is what the album would sound like, but
that's interesting. Kevin said, I hated Pet Sounds at first. That's, you don't hear that a lot. That's pretty interesting. Very cool.
I remember listening to that when I was 12 or 13 and I didn't hate it, but I was like, this is not, you know,
Bradley said MIU. I loved it in 78, but I don't like it as much as an adult man. Welcome to the club.
Yeah.
Not Matt's club, but, hey Jim. Oh man, we're on it. We have a lot of wonderful people in the chat tonight. Jim, have Jim back on. Jim, we need to connect and get back on because we love Jim Murphy. What an amazing author. Really, really great stuff. Unpopular opinion from Alex. I prefer the 1972 track listing for Carl Wilson's Smile rather than the 1967 version. I just think it works better without Good Vibrations. It feels more intellectual and refined. That's interesting. I didn't know Carl had his own track listing. Am I stupid for not knowing that, Matt?
I didn't know that either, but that does make sense because Good Vibrations was recorded way before that album anyway, and they just put it on there, you know.
Steve says Carl and the Passions kind of disappointing as time went on. Yeah, I agree with that. Some of the stuff on there, Matt, I don't know that I have a story like that as much as it seemed like everybody really loves Sunflower and Surf's Up, and I still can't get with those albums, man. I don't know what it is about them. Like, I really, there are some individual tracks that are my favorites, like Our Sweet Love, you know, Until I Die. But as albums, I can't find myself pressing play at the beginning and going all the way through. You know, I'd rather do that with like Keeping the Summer Alive. I don't know. But,
Sean had a great point, Greg, here. And this might be my problem. He said, in a way, it was more fun discovering the tracks on bootleg. And I think he's right about that. I think there was some excitement about like,
that's such
you know,
a good point. We
like,
all
what
did,
is this?
How,
where did this how, come from? You know, that's how we did it anyway. You
that's
know?
How we all did it back in the day, man. I remember I was trading with this guy. Am I allowed to say this online? Back
yeah,
in
I think
high
you
school.
Can now. Yeah.
Back in high school on, I think, Smiley Smile message board. I found this guy from Australia and he was so nice. He sent me a box of CDs And it had all bootlegs on it. And I lost my mind, man. I loved it. I remember sitting in the back of band class with my CD Walkman, with my ear things in. Cause I was a drummer in band. So basically you didn't do anything, you know?
Yeah.
So I sat in the back and I remember Matt getting 1966 Michigan State concert the first time. I couldn't believe it. Oh, I was in heaven listening to that thing.
But even with Smile though, you remember that? We would listen to those bootlegs.
Well,
and it was different. But you would just hear those renditions of there was this one part I remember listening to tonight, and it was just Heroes and Villains, but it was just like an orchestral part. It was do 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 with like the I don't know how, but it was crazy. You know, it was like, where did this come from? You know?
Yeah, what was your first Smile experience, Chad? I would want to know that. My first Smile experience was hearing Do You Like Worms from the 30th anniversary box set.
Yeah,
that blew my mind. I was like, what is this? I was obsessed with it. It was such a weird, I'd never heard anything like it before.
Yeah.
But I'd love to know, Matt, what was your first, was that yours?
That was mine too. And then after that, when I was in college and you got really into it, we would listen to the bootlegs. And I remember hearing, you know, again, Wind Chimes and Wonderful and all that stuff. And just, you know, the other vegetables. And anyway, it's to me, it's more fascinating. And again, I like the Smile sessions, but I think maybe part of it was my own fault because I played it in the sequence of albums when that's not really an album, you know. But I just listening to it, I was just like, I don't know about all these lyrics and they seem too flowery for me, you know, too abstract, you know. But anyway, it was just something. And no offense to Smile, again, Smile is brilliant. And I think if it had come out in 1966 or 67, by the time, you know, the way it was intended, I think it would have changed music for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I just think, you know, when you listen to today with all those beautiful melodies and you listen to Pet Sounds and then you put that on, it's just a little wild. It's quite a difference.
It is very wild. And Matt, I'm sorry. You want to talk to the chat for a second? I want to connect Annie here. I want to make sure she gets her link.
Yeah. Hello, Annie. My first Smile experience, this is Steve, was 2004 seeing Brian live in concert. Wow, I was only 16. You had never heard those songs. Wow. I saw the 2004 tour as well, but I had known some of the songs by then. But that was a great concert, by the way. Kathy, hello Kathy. It's been a while. Oh, sorry for your loss. Prayers for you, Kathy. Smarrington said my first Smile experience was hearing a BBC radio documentary about it in 1994. Bill said Jim Murphy wrote the best book on the Beach Boys. That book is awesome. It's called Becoming the Beach Boys. Look it up if you don't have it, but we have the author right in our chat tonight. So
we do.
We are honored to have him here.
Yes.
So get that book, cause it's for sure. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Okay.
Sorry, Brother Matt.
Wonderful. And Don't Worry, Bill was performed at live in 1972. That's true, Jimmy. Yep. It seemed like in 1972, Dirk's here. Maybe one of the experts is here. I'm pretty sure in one of those concerts, you can hear Carl say, or Mike, I think Mike says, we're going to release Smile this year. And that was in the early 70s. So I'm pretty sure that happens, right?
Yeah. He mentions it on one of the Carnegie concerts.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Right, I think.
I don't remember which one, but Sean said, I had Brian sign my first Smile bootleg when his book came out in 91. Craig, can you show, you got to show me yours, man.
I do. Let me take care of this for Annie real quick.
Okay.
And then
I got a story about that.
Do
Craig
it.
And I, and our, and our brothers, and a friend, we all went to St. Charles, Illinois to see Brian Wilson. It was a Gershwin tour.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, I can't wait to do a show on that album, Greg. I'd love to hear you sing those songs, but I love the Gershwin album. It's one of my favorites.
It's good stuff. Yeah.
Anyway, we're there. And this was rare at the time that, you know, you'd see Brian just, he's in the bus, like in the front seat. And then he just gets out with Jeff Foskett and just starts signing autographs. Again, that was pretty rare at that time. You know, you either had the meet and greets or he didn't do it. But anyway, so we were out there and I actually got a couple autographs, records signed for my friend. I said, give me your records. I'll get them for you signed. So I did. And I didn't get anything signed that time. I already had a couple autographs, but Greg had this bad boy and I couldn't believe he just gave it to Brian and he signed it without saying anything at all.
Well, because you have this moment where,
but you were scared about it though.
Oh, I was terrified because because at the time there's a lot of things wrong with this. Right. So number one is it's a bootleg. So I'm like, oh man, No, are they going to steal it from me? Are they going to call the cops? You know, I'm in high school. I'm scared about that stuff. And then the other part of it is that, you know, Brian and his history with Smile. This was before Brian Wilson presents presents Smile, and
it was after that. The Gershwin was after that. Yeah.
No, it was.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it was.
It was before the Smile sessions.
It was before the sessions or something. Yeah.
Right.
So yeah, I wasn't sure how he was gonna. No, dude, this was before.
It wasn't before 2004. 2004 was Brian Wilson Presents Smile. The Gershwin tour that came out later.
Okay, maybe I was just worried about, but I remember being very worried that he was going to.
You were, it was still, the Smile sessions were not out yet. That's what you were worried about. Yeah.
But this is definitely something that we are really excited to have. And it was a good memory. Great, great concert, by the way.
And I can't see it anymore. Giggins had a great, oh, here it is. Giggins said it was part, oh, by the way, Giggins, a legend again. Check out his pages. He said it was part of their contract to release Smile by May 1973, or they'd have to return their contract advance. Needless to say, they had to return their contract advance. Yeah, they didn't get it out. But I remember him talking about it. Dirk said it was the Carnegie Show, so thanks for verifying that. I know I heard it some. I think it's that Don't Worry Bill is from there. So anyway.
Sorry, Matt. I'm going to try and send this to Annie this way, too.
No, that's okay.
Let's see. Copy.
Okay. I had a tape from Adult Child and many demos. I don't know who that was. Sorry, I missed that one. Oh, it was Bill. I had a tape of Adult Child and many demos from the late Bob Haynes, who turned me onto a lot of great unreleased tracks. Bill, I got to ask you this question. On YouTube, there's some Brian Wilson videos, and they're called from Bob Haynes collection. And it's like Brian being interviewed during the Imagination era, and he meets Elvis Costello, and he meets like Sean Lennon, but he's really cool to see him in those because he seems very, you know, all there and lucid and making sense and stuff. Those are neat interviews. Maybe you know something about those, but I've seen those on YouTube before. I don't know if you've seen those, Greg, but they're pretty cool.
I have not.
It's Imagination Era, which I know you like too. So
I do. I love Brian's voice. I love his writing during that period. Really good.
And
he talks in those interviews about
about his songwriting process. Like he's all there. It's really cool. So that's the Bob Haynes collection. So anyway.
Awesome. Let me.
So good. I didn't take too much shrapnel for the Smile take, but. Oh, that's from Kevin said that's from Endless Harmony documentary. Yeah. And on the Endless Harmony soundtrack, it's on there. You're right. The Don't Worry Bill and Wonderful. Was Don't Worry Bill, was that a Flame song? Was that a Blondie and Ricky song?
I don't know, but I really like it.
Yeah.
I liked it a lot, actually. Yeah.
Oh, contract advance was $50,000, Dirk said. Wow, they had to pay. Well, they got popular in concert at least, so maybe they were able to pay it back. Gershwin was 2010. Okay, so maybe that came out after the Smile sessions. I don't know. I just remember we were scared. And he signed it, and it was
beautiful. Remember we were scared. That's funny.
Steve said, what do you guys think of the new drummer and guitarist for the current touring Beach Boys band? I haven't seen them in concert. I heard they're pretty good. I did see a picture of John Cousill with the new drummer. I guess he got to see him in Nashville as an audience member, and he commented on that, on how good they were. So I don't think at this point in his stage in his career, Mike Love wants to change anything too much, you know what I mean, and not have that authentic sound. So I doubt it changes much, you know.
Well, and he asked us, he said, hey, Matt and Greg, do you want to come and play drums and guitar and piano and just sing backups, maybe some tambourine and stuff? And we're like, dude, Mike, we would love to, but we've got this show on Tuesday nights, and that's our commitment right now. Yeah, you know, that's kind of what we're about. We're about
hey, Les,
doing this
here.
Next time. We said next time, Mike. Yeah,
one time. That would be bucket list. One time to get up there and be able to play drums on one of their songs.
How do we make that happen? Who do we talk to?
While Mike is singing, and that would be cool. I don't know, but that would be cool. Or play with Al.
No, wait. Forget just being up there. I want to play guitar and stuff. All right. Anyway.
Oh yeah. No. I want to play drums. That's what I'm saying. But
yeah.
Sonny said, "Surprise, Greg, you're not with Surf's Up and Sunflower."
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we are joined by the amazing Miss Wendy Wilson. Wendy, how are you? Can you hear us okay?
Hi. Yes, I can. How are you guys doing?
Oh, we are so honored you're here. Thank you for taking the time. It really does mean a lot.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yeah, let me
thank you. I'm honored to be on your show.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. Well, we're going to have a lot of fun tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, how about some hearts and love in the chat? for Wendy joining us tonight, being so gracious with her time. How was your Memorial Day? How was your weekend? Was it good?
It was good, actually. We're renovating a house right now, so it's all about the house. And we did nothing, basically. Oh. We just were at, we swam in our new pool, so we were very excited.
Yeah, renovating is always tough. Are you doing? Are you renovating the entire thing, or like room by room?
Yes. Well, we're actually it became more of a project than I anticipated. We're doing basically it's like stripped down almost to the studs, which wasn't expected. But yeah, no, it's really a big undertaking, but it's exciting, and I'm very nervous because I'm acting as a designer, and I've never done this before. So I hope it turns out great.
Well, honestly, if it's anything like what you've done in your career so far, I mean, television. I mean, we're talking music. I mean, you are so talented, and not only so talented, but you've been so successful. We were just talking about how young you were and how popular you guys were with Wilsonville. Mm-hmm. Just awesome. Anyway, we'll get there.
We'll get there. Yeah.
But our first question we asked all of our guests, and please forgive the question because I'm sure it's annoying and I'm sure you hear it all the time and probably want to kill us. But do you have a favorite Beach Boys song?
You know, I don't know if I have a favorite, to be honest with you. I mean, I have ones that I lean toward, you know, pretty typically. God Only Knows, of course, is such a classic. I love Busy Doing Nothing, just like a fun one. What else do I love? Hushabye. I love Warmth of the Sun. That's just a classic in my mind.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, there's so many great ones, you know, it's hard to pick.
Yeah.
By the way, I love your hat.
Thank you. Yeah. I appreciate that.
This was one of our questions. Yeah. I'll throw it in there since we're on the topic. Do you like the song Wendy? You got to love that one, right?
I do. I was a little confused as a child as to what that was all about, but I do. I love it now. I think it's very catchy. Yeah. It's cool.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm honored.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. A little bit deeper. Do you have a favorite album that you like to go to, or you're probably so busy. I mean, you probably don't have time to sit down and dig into a whole album, or anything have any special connection with you in terms of albums?
I think, well, when we were like teenagers, Capitol Records sent us box sets of the Beach Boys, I don't know, compilations of their music.
Uh-huh.
And it was a really great gift for us because we got to really study the music, delve into it and see it from a different angle. And I remember, I think one was called Friends, I believe.
Okay.
And I love that. I love that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, of course, Pet Sounds is great. It's more, you know, esoteric.
Right.
But I just like I like a lot of the songs where they're very much like, real and authentic to what they were going through at the time, you know, it's very simple.
Yeah.
Well, it's funny you say that because Busy Doing Nothing, a song you mentioned, that's on Friends. So,
yeah.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Do you remember? Do you remember what maybe musically, do you have a memory? What was your first experience musically? Do you remember being little? I mean, there's so many amazing pictures of you and Carney on stage with your dad and your uncles, everybody on stage. But in terms of your memory, what's like the first thing you remember from a music standpoint?
Well, I mean, probably being in the house and my dad playing the piano, you know, pretty much constantly.
Oh, that is so cool.
We would like sit with him on the piano bench and he would just kind of show us what he was doing. And he would love to play like I'm a Little Teacup, you know?
Yeah.
He loved to play that little rhyme for us. But it was just basically music was always playing in our home, you know, whether it was ELO, the Beatles, Fleetwood Mac, you know, those kind of bands. And we just were immersed in it. So it was always about the music. And I remember also being in the car with my mom, with our mom, Carney and I, and singing harmony in her convertible down Sunset Boulevard.
Oh,
yeah. She taught us how to sing in harmony. So that was a first memory.
Oh man.
That's a great memory. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, obviously, you know, we talk a lot about your dad on the show, if you can believe it. But you know, Do you remember like a first time? I mean, and I don't know how this works out growing up, just surrounded by it. But did you have a moment, maybe in high school or maybe a little earlier, where you kind of had a realization of kind of the profound effect that your dad's music has on people? And like, and was that a song or was an album? Was it like a moment where I'm like, okay, this isn't just my dad doing his thing. This is way beyond kind of that. It's such a weird question to ask because I'm not sure what it's like, but you kind of follow what I'm saying.
I mean, you know, like as a kid growing up in the music industry, whatever.
Yeah.
It was pretty much normalized for us. So we didn't really think of it as different.
Okay.
I think seeing other people's reactions to the music, you know, I don't remember a specific incident, but
right.
Seeing other people react to it and get like very emotional, or, you know, like maybe the press taking pictures or whatever as kids, we were like, whoa, you know,
yeah,
dad must be pretty cool, you know?
Yeah.
That's pretty much all I remember though.
Yeah. Yeah. I can imagine growing up in it. You probably don't realize it you probably get used to
yeah.
it. Well, how about you? But so you're so talented. You have an amazing voice. When did you, like, how old were you when you kind of realized that, like, hey, I can do this too. Like, I want to get into this.
Well, we were, you know, probably 16, and Carney was like 17 and a half, and China was also 17 and a half. Mm-hmm. And we would just sing together on the carpet on my floor in my bedroom, and just like harmonize because we loved it and it was in our blood.
Cool. Yeah.
And, so I think we didn't really know that we were going to be musicians at that point, mm-hmm. but we knew that we loved it and it felt great. So we started to write music, and then it just naturally progressed from there. So we were teenagers when we realized, right. then when we met with record executives, we kind of knew that something real was actually happening,
right.
and this could actually be a career, you know, but before that it was just for fun. Just singing harmony.
So because of your experiences with your family and when you get to that point of like, hey, I'm in front of some serious record producers, they're hearing our stuff there. Were you nervous or were you like super chill because you're like, this is what I've been around? Was there any sort of nerves there?
I think there were nerves. I think we were all a little nervous. You know, we were these young women with these like major executive men around us. Mm-hmm. It was all about the men.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. And, I think we were a little bit intimidated at the time and we didn't mm-hmm. really know that much, but we had people behind us that were supporting us. We had, you know, like managers and lawyers and our parents.
Right.
So that was always nice.
Yeah. Did you ever get to, and this is such a dumb question, but did you ever get to like bounce things off your parents? Like, did you ever like, hey, here's a song we're working on, or like, was there any sort of, not collaboration, but like you said, they were really supportive, and do you have any?
Yeah.
Example.
Well, I mean, my dad had already moved out by then. You know, my parents got divorced. So it was mainly my mother who we bounced off ideas to, and and China's mom, Michelle. So they were like the people that we, you know, kind of said, what do you think of this? And they were like, wow, this is sounding great. Keep going with it, you know? But our father, we from afar, I think he was supporting us.
Yeah.
Like, I remember getting letters in the mail sometimes saying, you know, I've been watching you guys. I saw you on this show or that show. And you know, I really love this record. You guys sound amazing. I love your voices. So we got support in that way, but it was really not very, it was kind of from a distance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you
but
have
we
a,
you know, he loved it.
Yeah.
Do you have a memory that sticks out, or maybe a show you did with Wilson Phillips? That's just maybe like a highlight, you know, of your career with them.
We've done a lot of shows.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't know if there was some like special one or something.
A lot of huge shows too.
Yeah.
I really would have to like really ponder that one. I mean, there was the Tokyo Music Festival, which we did, and we won first place, and that was exciting.
Oh, that's cool.
So being across the world and performing, you know, for the Japanese audience and, just like they were so polite, you know, we've never seen anything like it.
Yeah.
but yeah, that was pretty, you know, otherworldly. to be out there and doing that and then winning. Yeah. So, for sure.
And being, so Matt and I, we're brothers, and we have a little brother that I'm really close. We have three brothers. We have brothers and sisters. So we're used to that dynamic. But did you, what do you remember being little with Carney growing up? Did you guys, were you guys connected at the hip all the time? Or did you guys fight a lot? I know it.
Yeah.
What was that relationship like? Were you guys
always very close and fought a lot?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like normal siblings do, you know, it's just, it was typical, but, yeah, I mean, we got into fights, but we always made up and we were always very close.
Yeah.
You know, from day one, we had each other, we had each other's backs. So it, we were very much bonded, you know, even throughout our career together and our, you know, being just being siblings, sisters.
Mm-hmm. When you mention, we're jumping around a little bit here, sorry, but when you mention, it kind of has to go with your sister though, writing music, did you collaborate with her to write songs? And if so, what was that process like? How would you do that together?
You know, we would like sit down at the piano. Sometimes she would be on the piano. Sometimes I would. But we would just like sing some melodies together and try to find chords. And the words were always last, you know, what we wrote. But it just, I think melody is very strong in music. I think it's the part that everybody really remembers, you know. I mean, lyrics are very important and they're very powerful, of course. Yeah. But I think when you hear songs, you can know a song and not know the lyrics, but love it, you know?
That's right. Yeah. You that's hum true. The melody, right?
That
yeah.
is true.
Yeah. So yeah. I think that's very, very potent.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's how we would do it.
Going back to, you know, growing up around the band and the family and what... You know, Carl is my favorite Beach Boy. You know, growing up, I just loved Carl so much.
Yeah.
A huge fan. And how can you not be, right? But exactly. do you have any memories of him that you could share with us that, you know, any special moments you got to spend with him or just maybe in general what he was like?
Well, first of all, I can't say enough wonderful things about my Uncle Carl. I mean, he was such a dear person, such a love, and he loved his kids more than anything. He was a great dad. He was also a great uncle, always very sweet, loving, and supportive. And I remember, one thing I remember was he took us all out, all of the kids, the cousins, to drive. We were like eight, between like 8 and 12. And he let everybody drive the car.
Oh no. And, drive.
Well, don't forget, this was like the 70s. So yeah. We're a little more lax back then.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So we would like sit on his lap and he would let us drive the car. And it was such a highlight for us. And we were like, he's the coolest uncle ever. Yeah. So
that's good.
Yeah. He's awesome. He really was. He was the best. I miss him.
Yeah, and he worked with you guys in the studio on a few occasions, yes. right? And so what was that like? Did he ever impart like, hey, this is how we do it, this is how, you know, I'm sure he was very helpful in that way at some points, right?
Well, he didn't like instruct us in any way, but he, you know, he did his thing and he was very like, you know, nice about everything and easy to work with. His voice, of course, was the best. He had such a soulful.
My little girls love, and I love it too. Greg knows what I'm going to say right now.
I know exactly what you're going
to
say.
Christmas time. Hey, Santa. and then when you listen to the end of that song, when the tag comes on, all of a sudden you hear Carl. It's so cool.
Isn't it cool?
It really is to hear that voice and that song. Yeah. You know, it's a cool song anyway, but I was telling my daughters you were coming on. They were impressed. So they like that one.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. Cause he has that classic sound that no one else has, you know?
Yeah, exactly. So,
I feel honored that we got to work with Uncle Carl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have any stories from any of the other guys? And I don't know how it lines up, you know, in terms of Dennis. Did you ever get to spend any time that you can remember with him or, you know, any of the other Beach Boys?
I mean, I remember just like seeing Uncle Dennis, you know, like we would see him at family events, you know, parties or whatever. Yeah. And he was a real presence, you know, in the room and very loving, very like tactile.
Yeah.
Very like, I don't know how to say, like loud in a way, but not Actually, I will say it. I was a little scared of him.
Yeah, it's understandable. I mean, you're probably pretty little too at the time. So,
yeah. He was just a big presence, but he was sweet, and I don't have really that many specific memories of him. Just seeing him, with his kids, Michael and Carl.
Yeah.
And So, I mean, I remember him on stage. He was always really very energetic behind those drums.
Oh,
man.
Yeah.
Like he really gave it his all. And it was just fun. It was fun to watch him,
But we're, for sure. Tell us to shut up or, hang up if you want to, but,
never.
it had to have been, I'm sure it was an incredible experience growing up in such a, let's face it, rock royalty. I mean, your family, you included, you've made it a profound, contribution to the music industry, to rock and roll, to pop music, which I think is so cool. But there has to be some things that are challenging about being a child growing up in that, around that. Do you have, high level, any challenges you can share with us about growing up in that atmosphere? I mean, maybe not. Maybe it's just awesome all the time.
I mean, I pretty much blocked out my entire childhood.
Yeah.
Painful. No, yes, of course. It's not a normal lifestyle. It's not a normal childhood. And there's a lot of wounds there, that I'm still working through. I've gotten through most of it, but I'm still working through it. And it's just, all of the things that about my father and, his background and just being a child of someone in the industry in general. Mm-hmm. It's just that's a different life and they have more demands.
Yeah.
And then, they're not just demanded from their family, but from the public in general at all times.
Yeah. I mean, we have a show called Beach Boys Talk. So if that doesn't tell you how absurd we can get as fans, I don't know what I understand.
No, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's, every family has issues, I don't care who you are.
100%.
And, it's just, we have our own issues and, it wasn't a perfect childhood.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, but, there were a lot of great things too, a lot of exciting things that happened and the music is very healing too. That to have that is very special to have that in your family together that you share.
Yeah. Well, I was going to kind of ask you the other side of that is what have you found that's been really uplifting and kind of filled with a lot of love. I'm sure the music has kids, right? I mean, you have twins, right? Is that right?
I do. Yeah. I have identical twins that are 15. That's awesome. And then I have two older boys that are 18 and 19.
Yeah.
So four boys. Being a mom has completely changed me and given me a lot of purpose, I love it more than anything. That has brought me a lot of happiness in my life. And being married is great too. My sister, making music with my sister and China, and that I'm very proud of what we've done. I can look back and say, wow, we really did a lot and we really worked our butts off and, but look what flowered from that,
this might not be a reconnection, but I think, cause you probably have had a relationship with Al for a long time, but can you kind of talk about that? I know you're still touring with him now, correct? And his band.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I actually posted a video in anticipation of you coming out of you singing Sail on Sailor, which was pretty good with that band. So maybe talk about that too, how the whole thing works and everything.
How did you connect? I don't know how you connected with Al too.
Yeah.
I know. I love Al. So years and years ago, 20 something years ago, we played some shows with Al. We did 3 years of touring doing the Beach Boys music.
Yeah.
And that was a lot of fun. And then Wilson Phillips got back together and that was put on the back burner. But now, the past year, we've been back with Al and we've been doing shows and it's been great. Yeah. Like reuniting with him and his son, Matt, and some of the guys from the band, Bobby Figueroa, Ed Carter. Yeah. You know, it's just awesome. This is such a great group of people. I mean, they're so much fun to work with.
Yeah.
And very talented, of course. But just the energy, all we do is laugh, first of all. We just can't even, like, we can't even be in a room together without getting hysterical.
Oh, that's the best.
And as well as on stage. So that can be a problem sometimes.
Yeah.
But, but anyway, it's been great. Al is a great guy. He's so funny. Mm-hmm. He has such a great voice. He still has a great voice.
Yeah.
So, he loves to sing with us, which is an honor.
Yeah.
So we enjoy it too. It's a lot of fun doing the harmonies and singing these songs, you know, because he knows things. He has all the inside scoop from years and years and years of being a Beach Boy.
Right.
You know, that no one else can tell us, because we're like, what is this part again? Like, you just go down to B flat or whatever, you know? So he's an awesome guy, an awesome musician, and I'm glad we're doing it again.
Yeah. How did you guys connect originally? Like, I mean, obviously there's a relationship, right? But I mean, was he just like, hey guys, I'm doing this thing, come hang out with us, you know? Or was it, you know, how did that work out? Do you remember?
I'm trying to remember how it all came about. I think it was like a phone call. I think it was like, you know, we're going to be doing some gigs and, you know, we'd like you and your sister to join us and we think it's going to be great. And we were like, we're game. We're in, you know, it was that easy.
That's some fun. I love the laughing. I can totally see that too. Being around like that.
Does he ask you like, which songs, for instance, the Sail on Sailor, did you decide to sing that? Does he ask you, say, hey, I think it's a good idea, or just kind of talk, kind of agree to all that before?
That was actually my idea, because I wanted to challenge myself a little bit, you know, take out of my shell a bit. So I decided to take that on. I don't know if that was a good or bad idea, but
it was a very good idea.
Sounded good to me. Yeah.
It was fun. It is fun to do, you know, and it's a little more like gritty, you know?
Yeah.
So
oh yeah.
I enjoy it.
Yeah.
I enjoy it. But one thing that happened recently at a show, what happened? We got off the stage and Al is like very notorious for like saying like the most random stuff, you know? And so we get off the stage, we're all like amped up, we're like, that was a great show, everybody.
yeah.
And then I see Al and he's holding a jar of peanut butter and he's like, this is the best peanut butter I've ever had. He's like totally zoned on the jar of peanut butter, and everyone else is like
that's so good.
All pumped from the show.
That's
great. So funny.
That's so good.
It's hysterical.
I hate that we're bouncing back, because I wanted to ask you this when you're talking about your children. That had to be fun, knowing kind of what they're in for, like in terms of like crafting their experiences of hearing their, you know, their great uncles, their fathers or grandfathers, whatever that relationship is. Like hearing that music for the first time, did you, like, how were you thinking in terms of like, how am I going to present this as a parent, like, but also give them a really special experience? Like, did you make sure they had headphones on the first time, or was it like in the womb, you're like making sure you're blasting God Only Knows, or, you know, what was that experience like? Cause you have such a cool thing to share that not a lot of people do.
You know, it's not something I ever like pushed on them.
Okay.
It was not like that. It was like, you know, it was inevitable that they would hear it.
Sure.
Circumstances. And, just like we would see things on TV and I'd be like, you know, that's your grandpa. Or we'd be in the market and we'd hear a song and be like, there's your grandpa, you know,
that's the
Beach Boys. Yeah.
That's
so they're
cool,
like,
way,
they learned, you know, through the years, what the songs were. And, you know, I think they appreciate it a lot now. And actually my oldest son, Leo, he wants to be a singer.
All right.
He's been singing some of the songs that God Only Knows.
Yeah.
What else was he singing? Darlin'. He sang Darlin'.
Oh,
he's,
wow.
Yeah. And he sounds really good.
Let's go.
And I was like, I was in tears. He was singing God Only Know, Caroline No. And the tones are so Carl and my dad. It's crazy. And this is not something you can plan. this is genetics.
Right.
So mm-hmm. I'm like, I just start crying.
Yeah. Well, it's about your, I mean, out of, it's like statistics, right? There's somebody in the family that's going to have a really cool blend of those voices, right? And yes. Hey, maybe Leo's the next one to carry that torch, you know? That'd be awesome.
I would say it could happen.
Hey, we'll buy his records. Just let's do it. We'll be the first in line. I love that. I think that, does he play any instruments?
He plays a tiny bit of piano. Okay. But actually, my son, Beau, my second son, he just started playing guitar. He picked it up and he's learning really quickly.
Oh, this is working out great.
Wow.
Yeah.
So do one of the twins play drums and like maybe another one bass or what's
Well, actually, the twins kind of both play a little bit of drums, but they're more into rap music, and they're making mixes. They're doing beats.
All right. So that's their beat.
Yeah.
This kind of sounds like something needs to happen there. That sounds pretty great. I mean, you could have one of them rapping in between, and then all of a sudden you get some nice vocals on there. Pretty cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Enough.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Perfect. Oh,
that is so cool. I love that. Do you have time for maybe a couple more questions? We don't want to keep you too long.
Sure.
Okay?
Sure. Of course.
Greg, I had one from the chat. I've seen it a couple of times now. Would you talk a little bit about Greg and I actually got to go to the 2012 reunion, which was really cool to see special. All the surviving members up there.
Yeah.
But some of those concerts had, you were there with some of your sister and family members. Would you talk about that experience a little bit?
Wait, can you please refresh me on what that was?
Oh, it was the
California.
What was it called? The California Saga? California Music. It was during the 50th anniversary reunion tour.
Uh-huh.
And I think Matt Jardine was in it, and Carl's sons and Dennis's sons. You did a few concerts in California, I believe.
Oh, the Cal Saga. Right?
That's what it is. Yeah. Yes, yes, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It was really cool. I mean, you know, for the first time singing with our other, you know, our cousins, of course, and hearing the voices blend and it sounding very familial. It was great. We love them. And, you know, anytime we get a chance to sing with them or work with them, we jump on it. And Justin, of course, sounds like his dad. You know,
we were so lucky. Oh yeah. Go ahead. Sorry.
No, go ahead. No. And no, you know,
yeah.
Carl being, you know, he's a great songwriter and he can sing and he can play drums, you know? So it's really cool. And Christian, Mike's son.
Yeah.
So really an Amba. Just great to have everybody in Matt, of course, Matt Jardine, what a voice, man.
Oh yeah.
Right. Such a gift. It's just great to be with them and have that time and do this and create, you know, make something, make music.
Yeah. Well, as all the Beach Boys get older, I hope y'all bring that back. I think it would really, really be neat to keep the music alive that way. You know, something like that would be cool. So,
well, hey, it sounds like Leo's got this. I think I'm throwing all my chips in for Leo here. I'm in for it. Well,
so sweet. He's going to strangle me later for saying
that. No, it's,
but he is really good.
Hey, you know, talking about some of the TV shows you were on, I know, I think was it Super Nanny and like a lot of the shows throughout the years. Did you just feel like natural going into these situations where you're on these humongous TV shows and like, was it a different, completely different process?
My neighbor was the one who said, you guys should go on Super Nanny.
Uh-huh.
I don't think that was a compliment, but, you know, because our family was out of control, basically, you know.
Yeah.
I had just had twins.
Yeah.
It was 6 weeks after my twins were born, and I had a 3- and 4-year-old. And it was just complete chaos.
Yeah.
Sorry, that's my dog.
No, it's okay.
It was complete. Oh, boy. Katie. It was complete chaos.
Yeah.
As things are now. But yeah, so we just decided to go on Super Nanny, you know, and give it a try and say, you know what? We are like, I'm sorry about my dog barking.
Oh, that's
here.
Okay. It's Adolia. Okay, yeah. You can't hear too much. You're fine.
You know, it's like we're normal people, you know, we have problems with our family. We need help.
Right.
So it was kind of fun. It was fun, but they literally like we felt like we were kind of in prison for 11 days because we literally could not leave the house or talk to anybody.
Oh, no way. Really?
Yeah. No, it was good. I mean, overall, we had a great experience, but it was intense.
Yeah, and then you did, and you were also, was it the Masked Singer?
Masked Singer, right?
You were on that as well.
Oh yeah.
What was?
Oh yeah.
That was. You are awesome. That like what was what was that? I mean, that had been a pretty cool experience, right? I mean, what was
it
that
was
like?
A very, in retrospect, it was a very cool experience. A little painful, I'd be honest.
Wait, why is that?
The costume.
Yeah, you got to sing in a costume. It had to
well,
be
I
hard,
know.
Yeah.
Oh, that part was actually physically painful.
Yeah, it was just very uncomfortable. But you know, the costumes were absolutely beautiful and wonderfully made. Kudos to those designers. And the whole team at the Masked Singer were really, really flawless. I mean, they were awesome people and they run a very tight ship. Let me tell you. But it was a great experience. You know, overall it was hard, but I loved the fact that we got to incorporate the choreography and the vocals and everything was live and, you know, mistakes happen, but it was like the real deal. Like people used to be performers where they had to, you know, move their body and have choreography,
right,
and, you know, sing at the same time. Well, we never had that at Wilson Phillips. That we had a choreographer, but our moves were very minimal.
Right. Right.
You know? So this was different.
Yeah.
This was different. You had to remember your steps and, you know,
well,
and do everything
while wearing
you
a humongous mask.
Yeah, like wearing a big costume.
Well, wearing a humongous mask that you had no peripheral vision in. So it was.
You're right.
It
never
was
mind. That does sound awful. I think I would hate that. That would be. That
it was
would be,
a challenge, but it was fun.
Hey, last couple questions here, and we'll let you go. But how are your folks doing? As your mom, as your dad, how are they?
My mom is great. Best person I know. Mm-hmm. And you know, she's a very young 75-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
And she's just I try to model myself after her, so in every way. She's a real estate agent.
Mm-hmm.
And she does, you know, she does good work. She's happy with her husband. She travels, you know.
Did she sell you your house?
What?
Did she sell you? Did she really?
Well, actually, she bought it for us.
Oh, man, nice. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, very sweet person.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So, but anyway, yeah. And my dad, I mean, I haven't talked to him recently,
mm-hmm.
but I hear he's doing well.
Good.
You know, he had a back surgery, I guess, recently.
Mm-hmm.
And I hear he's recovered. So, I mean, I just want him to be happy and, you know, I mean, that's all I know right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I hear he's good.
Good. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah.
Okay, last question for you. First of all, we love Annie. She's just the sweetest people on the planet, and we love Billy. You know, we got to watch his show a lot. You know, unfortunately, you know, before he passed, he was actually he was going to come on to the show for an interview, and unfortunately, you know, he passed away, but what a wonderful person, and I'm sure it must have been so much fun having him around. Can you share with us your time with Billy, and maybe it's, you know, what was so special about him for you guys?
Billy was a very charismatic person, very funny, and he valued his family so much. You know, mm-hmm. they were everything to him, and loved his sister, my auntie, and he was very musical, very talented person, very much like when he focused on the music, he was very focused, and he wanted everybody to be right there with him,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I respected that about him,
yeah.
you know, because when he went to work, he really went to work, and
yeah.
he really took pride in being, you know, a musician. And I remember touring with Al, with Billy was in the band, and he was just a lot of fun. We always loved singing with him. He sang Sail on Sailor a lot.
Uh-huh.
But what else was I going to say? He was just funny because Matt and I, we had this like do-si-do that we would have to do. This was 20 years ago when we did. It was Sloop John B, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
And there was that part with the corn dance, you know?
Oh, yeah.
In the middle, yeah.
Yeah. And he wanted us to do a dance where we would do the do-si-do. And sometimes we would forget. And he'd be like, the dance. He would like yell it from his keyboards. He would get really mad at us.
Yeah, he was awesome. Yeah.
So cool.
Well, Wendy, you are so kind for taking the time to come hang out with us. I hope you had fun. We are huge fans. We think the world of you and your family, and thank you for all the music. Obviously not just your dad, your uncles, but you, your sister. I mean, I play Hold On at least 3 times a weekend. So I think I've played it every weekend for the past 20 years of my life. So I mean, it's just your music's amazing. Like, it really is. It's some good stuff. I've got Shadows and Light right here. It's a good record.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
I can't believe this. Yeah. Well, I am very, I'm honored by that. And I appreciate that you like the music,
Oh, yeah.
It's touching for me to hear that. I love that you guys are keeping the music alive through what you do. And thank you for what you do.
Thank you.
You guys are very cool. Where are you guys? Where do you live, by the way?
I'm in Cleveland, Ohio, rock and roll city.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I'm in Omaha, Nebraska.
So yeah.
Pretty boring out there. Yeah.
Yeah. We both went to LA for the first time ever a few months back, and Andy showed us around, and it was the coolest thing ever. Although it rained and was freezing the whole time, that kind of that was kind of a bummer. But
wasn't expecting that in California.
Yeah,
that's a little ironic. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Of course, I was like, man, the Beach Boys are full of crap. There's no sun here at all. They're singing about, but
yeah,
awesome. Well, hey, we'll be on the lookout for Leo, and please, thank you again for coming on the show. We really appreciate your time. It's such an honor to speak.
Yeah,
to
you. Really was. And hopefully you'll get a tour out one of our ways. We can come see the concert sometime. We'd like to
there.
Do that. So it'd be awesome. So
I would love that. Thank you guys. I loved being on your show, and take care.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Right. Take care, Wendy. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh man, she's so nice.
Yeah, she was great.
Yeah, it's I mean, I wouldn't expect anything else, but someone that's accomplished so much, you just don't expect them to be so super humble and kind. But
I was just gonna say that the humility, just and again, it's that idea. This is just what we were used to growing up. Our dad was Brian Wilson. We grew up with the Beach Boys. That's what they knew. That's why.
What's crazy?
I think some of that humility comes from there. It's just you're raised in a musical family like that.
But I think that they're really. I mean, both her and Carney are so special. I mean, they're special not just because obviously of the family connection, but I don't feel like in any way, I mean, I think they really made it on their own too. Like, I think they really went out and
for sure.
Completely kicked ass. Like, their records are great. Their harmonies were fantastic, and their music stands on its own. Like, and from what I heard from Carney too, it didn't seem like, I mean, I'm sure their dad had some input, but it seems like they did it, mm-hmm. I mean, like she mentioned, they had the support of her mom, and, but they were kind of doing it on their own, which I think is just so.
Their harmonies, by the way, are like pretty complex too. When you listen to some of those songs, it's not easy stuff that they're doing. You know?
Well, that's why I love their. I mean, because it's harmony, and that's why we all love the Beach Boys, man. That harmony is so great, and then that family vocal blend just doesn't stop.
I loved her Carl story that he would take all the kids driving. Pretty cool,
dude. That's really funny. I love
in the
that
70s.
Story.
Yeah, you didn't have to wear like seatbelts and stuff. So
yeah, exactly.
And the peanut butter story is really funny too.
That's pretty good. I like imagine. I don't know this true, but I imagine like Carl smoking a cigarette and like giving it to one of them while he's like driving, just like this whole.
How about the fact that she said, she wanted to do Sail on Sailor to challenge herself. So somebody who was in Wilson Phillips, platinum band, number one hits can just kind of ride on that, wants to go out and try a new song. I think that's pretty neat too.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like, it's not like they were a small band. I mean, they were the highest.
They were big.
I mean, they were huge. I mean, they broke records. I mean, it's like, it wasn't just like, oh, my dad's Brian Wilson kind of thing. It's
right.
Like, no, we're actually a legit thing. And we'll be probably remembered for a long time. I wonder if they'll ever be in the Rock Hall. They probably should, huh?
Yeah. Well, they don't put everybody in there.
They don't put good people into the Rock Hall.
No,
anymore.
They don't. No offense to people in there. I mean, but no, just another, Greg, another example of, first of all, thank you to Annie Wilson, but
thank you, Annie.
Just for making this happen. But the more people we meet, in this Beach Boys circle, you know, they're all really, really sweet people, you know.
They're all amazing. And
it's nice to see. Yeah.
Yeah, we haven't had a bad experience with, well, to be honest, we haven't really had a bad experience with anybody, but
No, not at all. But
especially like the folks that are related, they're all so well like grounded and you'd think going through some of the things that I'm sure that they went through that there would be some, and I'm sure there's damage there, but it certainly doesn't show up in their personalities. They don't seem to take it out on anybody, and they're just really kind. And like I said, I think Wendy and Carney get like even a one up in my book just because of what they were able to accomplish on their own, you know, and
yeah, no doubt,
put out records successfully and once again create timeless music without necessarily using, I think, that Beach Boy connection to help them. I think it's pretty awesome.
No, it was great. Cool. It was another thrill. I mean, you and I got to speak with both Carney and Wendy. Well, I mean, you know, who gets to say that, you know? So it's such a blessing we get to do that.
Well, hey, yeah, we all did it. Team effort.
We all did, yeah. But I mean, it's such an honor, you know, to be able to do that. So.
Yeah, it really is fun. Chat, thank you so much. And we mean that. I mean, this show has grown from me, Matt, and Dirk, and Claire, and you know, and the original Allison, folks, and Allison, to now we're a pretty big group now. And it's really fun to kind of see this thing grow, and it's all... It's all thanks to you guys. I mean, look, we're just...
And we wouldn't have the, be able to have fans. These guests no, if you all didn't come
it.
On the
I mean,
show.
None
that's
of these,
the thing.
None
so.
Of these guests would come on if you didn't join us. So we really... Because nobody... I mean, no one's just going to take a call from me and Matt just to randomly take questions. So even though we would love that. But thank you, chat. We really, really appreciate you. So, man, Matt, what a fun show.
Yeah, it was great. Love it. Love the interview with Wendy. And I really do want to see... I mean, think about it. The band that she's with... Her sister, Al Jardine, Bobby Figueroa, Ed Carter, you know, it's like the OGs of the Beach Boys band.
So
you know?
I could be wrong, but I thought somebody posted on Facebook that there are some new shows. Oh, it was Scott. Scott Meshnick said that I think there are shows that are being booked that aren't on their website yet. And I think they're coming this way, Matt.
I hope so.
We
I would
should
love
go out
to
of our
it.
Way. We could paint Wendy on our chest. No, I'll paint Wendy. You paint Carney.
Yeah, they may kick me out once they see
actually,
that.
That's true. they may never talk to us again.
No, but for real, it would be neat to hear that. And she said what she said was right about she was talking about her son, but the fact that it's in your DNA to have, you know, the tone and the voice, you know, and I think they have that too. So I would love to hear that blend up on stage with Al Jardine and Matt Jardine and the Wilson sisters. I mean,
yeah,
come on,
and,
you know.
Bob Vaden mentioned Proben Gregory. We've had him.
Yeah,
on
and
the Proben
Gregory's on is in the band too.
Yeah, we've been lucky. We've had most of their band on, right?
Yeah,
we have kind of.
Yeah, we have.
Who else? Who are we missing there?
We had Bobby on. We had Wendy Carney. We had Matt Jardine on.
Yeah,
we
did.
And we had Proben. I think there's a keyboard player. I don't know her name.
Okay, we got to get
also,
her on.
But,
we got to get her on. Does anybody know? Yeah. Does anybody know her name? We should reach out and see if she wants to come on and chat.
Hello, Mara. Road trip for the BB Talk fam. Yeah,
that'd be fun. That would.
No,
be fun.
you just get the insights of, like I said, of these folks. It's pretty neat. So she's great.
Yeah,
I loved it.
That was a lot of fun.
I don't know what else to say except it was just it's fun to chat with them.
yep so. Really sweet folks. Well, Matt, what do you want to do? You want to do some songs or you want to end it? What do you want to do?
You want to play a few? You can play a few.
Should we take some, we can do some fun Beach Boy requests. We could open up the request line. If y'all want to hear a song, let us know. Matt and I will try and shove our way through it while we talk Beach Boys and we read the chat. Allison says, what did I miss? Allison, Brian
Miss
and
Wendy
Al
Wilson.
Got on and sang a duet of an unreleased Smile song, and now you missed it, and it's gone forever. No, Allison, we're just kidding, obviously. But, no, we had Wendy on, and she was awesome. Really, really, really sweet, so talented. It was great. We had a lot of fun. So, Patricia says, spin the wheel. Matt, you want to spin the wheel?
Oh, Cal, yeah. Hey, you could do that, just... Spin the wheel.
we're gonna spin the wheel, everybody. We brought this to the show last week when we were trying the Club Kokomo cocktails. By the way, shout out to Club Kokomo. Thank you for sending us some cocktails to try. Which was I don't even know if that was a good idea or a bad idea. Let's just pretend that show didn't happen. But
thanks
we created
for that,
this wheel.
The hangover at Club Kokomo. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, right. We didn't drink that much.
I'm just kidding you.
Yeah. We'll spin the wheel. Let's see. We'll see what this will decide what we do right now. Here we go. The Beach Boy talk wheel spinning in 3, 2, 1. Let's give it a try. Oh yeah. Look at that thing spin.
Taylor said a whole lot.
The Brian Wilson from Sunny. We still haven't come up with a good name for this one.
The Wilson.
Matt, we got to do a giveaway.
All right.
Let's give away. Let's give away a T-shirt or something from our website. You guys can buy, or you can also on our website, you can buy the MIU Fan Club T-shirt, which was a pretty big hit. People like that one. So
Al Jardine has one.
Al Jardine now has one.
McCrina says, "Make it the shirt." No, that's not on the wheel anymore.
It is on the wheel. It's still on the wheel. So Annie was so kind to send a cutoff. It's a cutoff. What is it? It's like a tank top, a Beach Boys tank top.
Sleeveless, yeah.
But it's funny because it's like a small on Matt, and it's on the wheel for him to put that on. And I think, cutoff. The cutoff is the blue right here. So, Matt, let's give away, let's ask a question. We're going to ask a question in the chat. The first one to answer the Beach Boy trivia question, the first one that we see, so we'll win something from our Beach Boy Talk store. Just connect with us. And we'll get you hooked up there. But Matt, what question should we ask? I know you've got some trivia, don't you?
Yeah, I'm trying to pull one up. Hold on.
All right, Matt's going to pull up some trivia. I'm going to play this car of mine while Matt's pulling up some trivia.
All right, good idea.
What key is that in? Matt, what key is this car of mine in?
This car of mine, when I got her now, she wasn't new. I'm pretty sure that's it. Old and broken.
Yeah, that's good.
This car of mine, when I got it out, she wasn't new. Old and broke down. This car of mine, there've been a lot of races we've been through. No, so poked down, I never want to part with her, you see. But see, the car means a heck of a lot to me. Remember the day when I chose her over all those old junkers. Thought I could tell underneath the cold a rush she was gold. No clunker, I didn't want to buy up. Ain't no amount of gold in any mine could be enough to take away this car of mine. This car of mine. This car of mine. This car of mine. Car of mine. Oh, oh. Oh, this car of mine. She's oh so fine now.
All right, this car of mine by request. All right, Matt, you got it?
Yes.
Okay, remember, the first person to answer this question in the chat will win. And you may not want to win it, and it's okay. You won't hurt our feelings. But you'll win something from our website, beachboystalk.com. You can buy yourself a T-shirt or a mug. Matt, what is the question? Here we go.
What name did Murray Wilson use as a co-writer for the song Breakaway?
That's a good one. I don't even know what it is. I forget. Here we go. The first one we see, Matt. I'll know it when I see it. I'll know it when I see it.
What name did Murray use as a co-writer for the song Breakaway? Elias, I guess, would be a better
alias. Way to
say that, but alias, yeah. Elias.
First one is The Old Outlaw.
What did he say?
Reggie Dunbar.
That's correct. Reggie Dunbar. Now you got to play a little Breakaway. Outlaw, just message Greg or me and we'll hook you up there. Congratulations. A lot of people know that one. Time will not wait for me. Time. That might be even lower than what it is, but.
Is that,
time will. Is my time is my destiny. Yeah, that's it. Why change the part right. of me that has
right,
to be?
All right, let's go.
By the way, the a cappella version of this, the harmony there, it's incredible.
That's not right. Hold on. Okay, hold on, Matt. Give me a second.
I don't know why he went over the name Reggie Dunbar. That's a good question. Anybody know why he did that? I don't know.
God wait for me. Time is my destiny. Why change the part of me that is to be free? Before I thought of it, I had been out of it. And here's the answer I found this day. Found out it was in my head. Found
the more I
thought of it, thank you. I had been out of it. And here's the answer I found instead. Found that it was in my head. Found that it was my head. Found that it was in my head.
Awesome. Scene, man, I suck, but that is an awesome song.
That's a great song. Another one of those. It's not on a not on an album per se, just a random single that Brian thought would do well, and it didn't do well. But it's a great song.
Okay, Matt, let's spin the wheel two more times, and then we'll call it for the night. But I think we're gonna I'm feeling lucky right now. Oh, Allison requested "Keep an Eye on Summer." I love that song.
Oh,
all right, we'll do "Keep an Eye on Summer," but let's spin the wheel first. Please get the cutoff. You're gonna put it on if we get it.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. It's part of the show. You promised.
I need more Club Kokomo to do that.
We're all out of crud. Okay, this is dumb. This says, ask Greg anything. Ask me
there
anything.
There you go.
Here we go.
I do want to give a shout out to John Butler. He's here. He said he ordered a bunch of those Club Kokomo things. So hopefully we helped them get a little bit of sales with our show last week.
Yeah,
but that's cool, John.
Tell us what you think about the Club Kokomo.
Let me know what you think about it. Yeah.
I especially love Mystique.
Save one for me too, man. We'll have one together.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Okay, ask Greg anything. Yes, cut off. Stop that. Michael, you said a trivia night would be fun. We've done trivia nights in the past, and they've been fun. Joyce says, Greg, do you still have your piano bar? Macrina asks you, Greg, what is your favorite song to perform?
Oh.
And Greg, are you going to any Beach Boys shows soon?
Okay, let's do those three. Yeah, I do. I have a couple companies that do piano, dueling piano bars and stuff like that. So I love a good dueling piano bar. If you've never gone to a really good dueling piano bar, we have one in Nashville, and it was awesome. If you're near any big cities, they always have a good piano bar, so make sure you go. What was the other question?
What's your favorite song to perform live?
Favorite song to perform live? That's a good one. Okay, this is going to be stupid. Besides any Beach Boys song, I would say I love doing Bryan Adams. I love doing any Bryan Adams, man. Bryan Adams just great music. Really fun to belt and sing. So, good question.
You plan on going to any Beach Boys songs?
If I can't, my biggest problem is because I'm in the entertainment industry, I work every like on nights and weekends, and those are tough because a lot of times you know, if there's like a random Wednesday night show, which I think Mike is coming into town to Cleveland, he's doing a Wednesday night show. I might try and do that. So it'll be kind of fun. So
Old Outlaw said, hey, Matt and Greg, he wants to forfeit his winning. He's overseas, so we can give it to somebody else or do it again or whatever. So
all right.
No problem. And then also, Steven wants to know, who's your favorite Star Wars character? And that's our Steven.
Oh, Vader.
Our little Steven.
Dude, Vader. if anybody answers anything other than Vader, they're not a good star. They're not a true Star Wars fan. Vader all day. I love it. Okay. May want to keep an eye on Summer?
Sure.
All right. And then we'll spin the wheel one more time in the hopes of getting Matt Wears a Cutoff. All right. Matt, I'm going to need help with the lyrics on this one.
Okay. We said goodbye.
Oh.
This one's tricky.
There it is.
We say goodbye last September. Your words I still.
Those things I say.
Oh,
those things I say in my letter.
I say in my thank you.
My letter.
You'll find them all sincere. Keep an eye on summer.
Thank you, Taylor.
This
That's a good job, buddy. That's one of my favorite Beach Boys songs.
Dude, what an awesome song. That's one of those songs, Mayor, where it's like, it doesn't matter if you're good or bad at music. If you just sing it and just let it happen, it's such a good song.
Yeah, it's like Wendy talked about the melody. The melody in that is so good. You know?
Oh, Wendy nailed it. That's right.
Yeah.
She made a really good point. She's like, there are so many songs where you know that melody, but you can't remember the lyrics.
Yeah,
I think that.
Yeah, she's right.
Yeah. All right, Matt.
And that's That's a great Brian Wilson.
We're gonna
spin
the wheel one more time in the hopes of getting the cutoff.
Off
you ready?
Shut Down Volume 2 album.
That's true. Have we done that album?
Yeah, we did.
We did.
Uh-huh.
Can we do it again?
I know. It's got that one and Warmth of the Sun and Don't Worry Baby. I mean, what an album!
What an album! And Denny's drums. Are you kidding?
Yeah, I forgot about that one.
Denny's drums. That's such a
Louie.
Okay, we already did that one. We gotta do a new one. It landed on the
fun,
same
fun,
thing.
Fun.
In the Parking Lot? Dude,
yep.
That song
pom,
rocks.
Pom-pom play girl.
Pom-pom play girl. Ra-ra, pom-pom play. Oh, we keep getting the same one. Hold on. Okay. I promise, I'm not just trying to get the cutoff here.
Oh, you played This Car of Mine. That's from that album, too.
Oh, This Car of Mine. Classic. Yeah. All right, let's do one more Beach Boys song here. Last song of the night.
Is that what it landed on?
Yeah.
All right, good. All right, let's see one in the chat. Chat went a little bit by, so I didn't see if you wrote something before.
You guys want to hear a song? Our last song of the night, and Matt's got to sing it. How about that? How about Matt? Matt, you want to do a duet?
No,
you want to do a duet with me?
Maybe we can do that.
Well, we should use some Wilson Phillips.
I don't think I could know those songs well enough. I know You're in Love. I like that one.
You're in love. I know that.
That's a good one, too.
I know this pain.
I think that's my favorite one.
Why do you lock yourself up in these chains?
Oh, all right. We're doing this. All right. We're doing it. It's happening. Come on, Matt.
Dude, I don't know Wilson Phillips well enough to sing that.
We'll learn it.
Greg, Matt, do a Beach Boy biopic episode. That's a good idea. Well, I could learn for another show, but
that
I can't. I don't,
okay.
I don't know.
Let's do some
song.
Wilson Phillips. Here we go. In honor of Wendy. Here we go. I have to make sure I do the lyrics right. Hold on.
Michael, is the BB Talk with Matt Jardine available on YouTube? It is. It's it's our season finale. Well, we had him on twice actually, but we had him on once as a season finale in honor of Billy Hinchy, and then we had another episode where he was on. But I think they're both on there. That probably wasn't helpful. But,
okay, you ready?
Learn it, Matt. Okay,
learn it. My just brother. Learn it.
Oh, yeah, Claire said,
I know this pain.
You changed the album cover on Matt's faces.
Why do you knock yourself up in these chains?
Shut down volume two, remember?
What are you talking about?
Claire said you forgot that when you did that episode on the you changed all the faces to my face on the album cover.
That's right, they're all at the car and it's all your face.
Yeah, she said she was laughing.
I forgot about that. Okay, sorry.
I know this pain. Why do you lock yourself up in these chains?
Michael, maybe I'll put it in the chat here.
No one can change your life except for you. Don't ever let them one step over you. Just open your heart and your mind. Is it really bad for you this way inside? Someday somebody's gonna make you wanna turn around and say goodbye. Until then, baby, are you gonna let them hold you down and make you cry? Don't you know, they can change, they go your way. But you hold on, darling, for one more day. And you hold on for one more day. Things are going your way. Hold on for one more day.
Nice, Matt. Let's get out of here.
You could sustain. Wanna turn around and say goodbye. Until then, baby, are you gonna let him hold you down and make you cry? But don't you know, you can change, you go your way, but you hold on, darling, for one more day. And you hold on for one more day, things will go your way. Hold on for one more day.
Gentlemen, all the way from wherever Matt's from. That's Matt Coffey over there, my big brother. Big thank you to Wendy Wilson joining us on the show tonight. That was a really fun interview. I'm gonna go back and
it
watch
was.
This. A good
thank you everybody that came on the show.
Yes, thank you all of you out there for joining us tonight.
We had a big crowd tonight, Greg.
We had a huge crowd tonight. I don't even know what it was tonight because I messed up the thing, but I'll find
it
out
was,
afterwards.
It was one of our biggest, I
oh,
believe.
Oh, really? You think so?
If not our big. Oh, yeah.
Hey, we might have broken some
I
records
saw
tonight,
had,
you guys.
We had 80, 85 on Facebook and 70-something,
oh, no
80-something on YouTube as well.
Holy,
so it was pretty big.
Holy crap, this might have been our.
Yeah.
All right, let's party. So,
and again, another shout-out and thank you again to Annie for
Annie.
Making this all happen. We can't do it without you. Annie. Thank you for being here, Dirk. good to see you here. Yeah,
good to see everybody here. Hey guys, thank you again for joining us. We love you. We'll let you know what the show situation is next week. But as always, every Tuesday night, make sure you join us here. We love y'all. Everybody, have a wonderful night. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.